शिव पिता को अब याद करो, मुक्ति धाम तुम्हें जाना है। अपने सुकर्मों के बल पर ही सतयुग में तुमको आना है। शिव पिता को अब याद करो। सतयुग में अब तुम्हें आना है।
धाम में तुम्हें
सतयुग में अब तुम्हें आना है।
धाम में तुम्हें जाना है।
ओम शांति। I just continue little bit from what Mirabhan has left. Mirabhan spoke about the immune power. Yeah, we know that as yogis, our immune power ought to be very strong, because we are more powerful than the COVID virus. The COVID virus is visible, but the soul is not visible. So therefore, the more subtler, we know that the spiritual knowledge says, the more subtle you become, the more powerful you become. So therefore, when we practice a lot of soul consciousness, which again, it ought to be our behavior, and over a period of time, develop a degree of confidence that I, the soul, I am really, really, really powerful. Nothing can control me. I am multi-million times stronger than the COVID virus. So that's one of the way we should think, that we always remain above. Yes, we think about the problem because we want to solve problems. But whilst thinking about the problem, now and then always remember that you are above all these things. So therefore, whatever I'm talking shouldn't affect me unless it is affecting me in the positive way. Yeah. Okay, our life, we are Brahmins and our spiritual life is governed by four subjects: Gyan, Yoga, Dharana, and Seva. Now it is time of COVID. And I am staying in the center, isolated, far from the city. There are very small number of students. And then there is the law which says that it is total control, that nobody should move around. And so nobody comes to the center. What happens to me? I am isolated. On one side, this isolation is good. But on the other hand, we Brahmins, unless I'm so powerful, I should not be isolated. Because anytime anything can happen, if I am alone, I can talk to somebody, and then it's easy to be influenced by Maya. So therefore, the isolation, there is benefit and there is problem also. Okay, with Gyan, I can churn a lot of Gyan. And then with yoga power mix, then the Gyan becomes living. And that Gyan becomes my Dharana. Once there is Dharana, then I want to share my transformation with people. And then the sharing of transformation will create impact in them because I feel my own transformation. So our yoga, our dharana should be such that it is so strong that we are very, very deep. We will not be able to be shaken by any weaknesses of others, of negative vibrations around us. So then the seva will be powerful. So in terms of isolation, now I don't have this chance of doing service. Now as a Brahmin, if I don't do service, it is not a life. I have to do service. But now I am not able to do service. I'm deprived of doing service, talking to people. So how do then I do service? Then I have to be creative. Now is the time that I can use my mind power and start thinking elevated thoughts about myself, elevated thoughts about the environment, about the future, about people, that I make a commitment that I just want to look at everything positively. And in that way, I can serve others through my mind, meaning to say, I can see myself powerful and that my power can reach the family that couldn't come to the center because of the law. So that's one way of doing it. And also, when I am alone, I have two choices. I mentioned the laziness part, which may come in if I am not alert. But if I am the type that I want to drive my life, you know, I don't want to be driven by things, but I want to drive my life, then you will be enthusiastic. These days, what we do is that because there is not so many service to do, then we ask people to read Murli, as Miraben was sharing, you know, that read Murli every day. One Murli, one day Avyat Murli. A group of people will read, or some listen through online. So they get something every day of Avyat Murli. And you know, Avyat Murli is always very powerful. So in that way, their time is used in a worthwhile way. Basically thinking more and more about transformation. So then the students also, we always, we the most important person in the center is the center coordinator. So center coordinator, for whatever reason, during the time of difficulty, they must maintain their communication with the national coordinator so that, you know, there is some communication, any help is needed, we can do. So similarly, center coordinators also, we tell them they are not able to come to center, but you can call them and talk to them, share some gyan with them, and to make sure that their mind is filled with gyan and their life is happy. So in that, this way, we sustain people. But in some places, there are online classes. So they listen to Murli class by online, and also in a week, three times, there are Murli churning class also. So a lot of this kind of activities are taking place. But you know that not all the places have access to online things. Some places there are no online things. In Malaysia, online services, a lot of online services are really centralized. Many public programs are organized from one center, but the planning of it is taken place by the participation of many other centers. But the control, the main person, the person is controlling the online thing, that's from one place, only one or two places. So what will all other small centers, what will they do? How will they keep themselves busy and so that they are always able to remember Baba? So this is something that we really have to think about. Some points I already mentioned just now, but there must be some other method. A lot of people have complained also, you know, we don't know what to do. Old mothers say, we used to go to centers and wash the utensils, cut vegetables. Now we cannot go. What service we can do at home all the time? So this kind of problems are also coming. So we have to teach people. One of the things is we have to teach people to go online. Even mothers, you know, if they really want to listen to Baba's Murli, they will somehow learn, you know, how to use the computers. We just switch on and then tell them to operate, teach them many times, they can do. I know in one center, the center Vasi has given them a cell phone, and they can get link to the online classes by themselves. In a simple way, he teach them and they are quite happy. So these are the kind of changes that we have to bring in our way of managing the center. You know, in many countries, they said during this period of time, the service expanded a lot. But I know, at least in Malaysia, it has not expanded a lot. We did many online service for public. A lot of people come, but for taking courses, not many come. And probably in India too, the same. So Sister Shivani also mentioned, when you are organizing public program, also organize a follow-up program for those who want to take a course or another public program. So we are trying on that one. We realized that we are not good at marketing. For many years, we have been doing marketing in the same way only. Then suddenly, one brother who is a long-time Brahmin, now willing to come forward and help us. And he is good in marketing. His job is marketing. So we are going to form a team and create many groups so that we can do proper marketing, so people can, more people will come and take 7 days course also. Some say, oh, your branding has to change. You must make something neutral. People come and then people decide, you know, what they want to take. But I know BK policy is, you know, we from beginning, we invite invite those of the BK quality. They will come. That's our current policy, as far as I know. So also to build this year, from last year, we have put in a lot of capacity building in the IT area so that we are able to, you know, help all the centers. And where possible, we can also play some role of coordinating the activities in the region so that many people in the countries around in Asia can take maximum benefit. So we want to embark on providing training. We have done once, but we want to do many times so that more people can really learn this art and become more resourceful, no more, more creative. Also, you know, when they attend a lot of classes, okay, they go here, they go there, but end of the day, they are tired. No? End of the day, listening so many classes and then tired of listening. So what's the benefit then? That's why I believe that, yes, you should listen, yes. And then absorb the points, at least some points, and then churn on the points. Keep churning on the points until you come to a conclusion. Some points from the classes shared make a lot of impact in you, where then your heart says, yeah, this is it. This is it. So to that level, we should keep churning. And then that is how we actually own the knowledge that we have taken from the Murli or we have taken from others' classes, you know. Okay, now even some of the problem in this COVID time and online classes is, we always put meditation clips, video clips, yeah, because this is very creative, and a lot of people take support of these video clips. But a day will come, we will not have video clips, so. We should learn in such a manner that for the time being, use all these things. But finally, I must be able to create a video in my own mind. And through that vision, that imagination, I should generate my energy during the meditation. As Suraj Bhai was explaining how he was talking to himself during the Amrit Vela time and all that. So we must also ensure that we can become free from all these dependencies until you come to a level that you yourself feel that, no, I don't need video clips. I can be very independent. You know, so these are some of the things that we were sharing. You know, for survival part, okay, in terms of spiritual sustenance, that's that. Now, the protection of the body. In India, you know, comparatively, a lot of BKs died. In the beginning, nobody, everybody was happy. Everybody was telling, oh, no BKs were attacked by COVID, no? But then after some time, they become sort of less attention. They don't wear mask. In India, in Shantivan, we can say, you know, don't wear mask properly. Then, you know, one wave after another came, and also Brahmins were also affected. So therefore, we have to be very careful. We cannot afford to be careless in the way we wear our mask. Today, I heard one report that says that COVID-19 is airborne, which means that it remains 8 hours in the air. So they say that now, as you go out, you must wear. It's not a question of whether somebody is around or not, but this thing is already in the air for 8 hours. So we have to we are the one who must really become example for others, because of COVID has mutated quite a lot. Today or yesterday, they were announcing that the one of the strain from South Africa has entered Malaysia. And this thing, this COVID, it can spread very fast, it seems. So the moment you sense that you got this COVID, one has to take immediate medication, and then there can be medical support. Otherwise, you know, like everybody else, there's a lot of problem. There's not enough beds, not enough oxygen. All these things in Malaysia are so there. Malaysia's percentage in terms of ratio is quite close to India in terms of ratio per person per thousand, very close to India. So we are very worried about the situation. So my conclusion is that we must be really, really very careful about Corona. I remember one case in one family, three people, you know, father, mother, and the child. The child also is grown up. These parents didn't go out, but the child, he goes out and come. And then the parents got the corona because the boy didn't have symptoms, asymptomatic. He doesn't have the sickness. He was not detectable, but he carries the virus. That means he is strong. So virus goes through him and then through his the air that he releases. So it affected the parents and both parents died. So therefore, our policy is always every other person is a potential danger. You know, he has to wear mask and I have to wear mask. And this is really cooperation. We shouldn't be lazy or, you know, for whatever reason, if we are among others, we must wear the COVID so that we can be continued to be protected until some real vaccine is found, and hopefully we can get freedom from this pandemic so that we can proceed to next level of service. So thank you so much. Hopefully some of these points are useful to you. Okay, Om Shanti.